Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's go through colpotts oscillator, guys. Guys, these oscillators are really important, guys. There is a 100% 5 marks question. You need to learn six things about oscillators. The first thing, it's generalized solution, and the five other types of oscillators. So these six are going from these six, you are going to get any one. That's a compulsory question, guys, for 5 marks. Okay, so in this tutorial we'll be going through colpotts oscillator. In the previous tutorial we have gone through Hartley oscillator. So basically, if you see the diagram, it is perfectly similar to Hartley, whereas here there are inductors and here in that it is capacitor. So these two are interchanged, and here we are having two capacitors and one inductor. Got it? Okay guys, so now let us go through the main points of colpotts oscillator. The colpotts oscillator, Z1 and Z2 are capacitors, C1 and C2, and Z3 is a inductor. So I hope everyone is now 100% clear with it, right guys? Okay, and resistors R1, R2 and RE provides necessary DC bias to transistor. So this is also similar point to that only. That only means that's Hartley oscillator, guys. Okay, and CE is a bias capacitor. Same, C1 and C2 are the coupling capacitors. Feedback network consists of inductor L1 and capacitor C1 and C2. When the supply voltage VCC is switched on, a transient current is produced in the tank circuit, and consequently damped oscillations are formed and set up in the circuit. Yep, if the terminal 1 is positive with respect to 3 at an instant, the terminal 2 will be negative with respect to 3 at the same instant. Yeah, that's also a repeated point. And thus the phase shift or phase difference between the terminal 1 and 2 is always 180 degrees in between input and output. Yeah, that's fine. So the total phase shift will be 360. 180 from the tank circuit and 180 directly from the CE amplifier. Okay, so now we are done with the first one point. So now the next point will be, if the feedback is adjusted so that A beta is equals to 1, then the circuit acts as an oscillator. So now let us try to analyze the equation for the same process for the colpotts oscillator. This is also the same process, guys, but I have told you one thing. Here there is only a single inductor, so there will be no mutual inductance. Remember guys, that's the most important thing. If you write it, you are going to screw the whole theorem or something like that. So Z1 is nothing but 1 by JWC1. I'll be sending J to the numerator, minus J by WC1. Z2 is 1 by JWC2, sending J to numerator, minus J by WC2. And further moving on, Z3. I have told you that there will be no mutual inductance. So directly JWL, that's it. So we know the generalized equation is nothing but HIE into Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 plus 1 plus HFE Z1 Z2 plus Z2 Z3 is equals to 0. So now replacing the values of Z1, Z2, Z3 with the above values, so we're gonna get an equation like this, guys. So in this, take as many J's possible for the starting point, guys. So we got a J here, and these two J's multiply to form minus. So minus into minus plus, minus into plus minus. So we're gonna get minus. Okay, that's here I wrote. Okay, that's fine. Plus, here we are having J into J, that is minus 1, minus into minus plus. So we're gonna got plus. Fine. So this is our imaginary part, right? So if we make the imaginary part equals to 0, we're gonna get F. So I have just tried to make it. I have sent this whole part to the other side. So 0, omega square L is equals to 1 by C1 plus C2. Omega is equals to under root 1 by L into 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, where omega is nothing but 2 pi F. So we'll be dividing on the other side with 1 by 2 pi. So F equal to 1 by 2 pi under root 1 by L into 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. Fine. So further moving on, we can directly say that real part is equals to 0 now to find HFE. So the equation should have HFE. If you observe, it's here. So C1, C1 cancel. send this that side. So we already have the value of w square. So we'll be substituting the value of w square. So again, we tried to make it in terms of plus 1. So we have just cancelled them. So these two got cancelled and we have got minus 1 here. So minus, that's C2 by C1. HFE we got, that is equals to C2 minus C1. And F we got 1 by 2 pi under root 1 by L into 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So now I hope everyone is now clear with Colpitts oscillator. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through RC phase shift oscillator, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.